Hello, Brian Park. What a beautiful evening we have tonight. My name is Dan Fishman. I'm the Vice President of Public Events here at Bryant Park. Again, so glad to see all of you here. Tonight's event is part of Bryant Park Picnic Performances presented by Bank of America. All summer long on this stage and this lawn, you can see free music, theater, and dance. Let's give a round of applause for free arts in New York City. I would like to give a special shout out to Bank of America, our continued long-term partners of Picnic Performance. Yeah, they deserve a round of applause too. Bank of America believes in the power of the arts, and we could not do these shows without them. Some housekeeping tonight. We have some wonderful food and drink vendors in the white tents and the green tent over there. Please do check them out. We also have the Bryant Park shop. Please buy some merchandise. I believe there is even a pineapple sangria special at the beer and wine tent, which I've been told to shout out, so please do check that out. If you brought a blanket onto the lawn and you're able to return that on your way out, please do so, and same with chairs. Tonight is our third event in partnership with Joe's Pub. And Joe's, yeah, let's give a round of applause for Joe's Pub. They do such amazing work for New York City. And honestly, when Joe's Pub and I were thinking about who should be on the stage this year, one of the first names that came to mind was the performer you're gonna see tonight. And just to tell you a little bit more about Shaina Taub, Shaina Taub is an Obie Award-winning, Emmy Award-nominated songwriter and performer. She's an artist in residence at Joe's Pub and at the Public Theater, where she wrote and starred in Suffs. Round of applause for Suffs. Fantastic, fantastic show. Garnering Drama League, Drama Desk, and Lortel Award nominations. Her three solo albums include Songs of the Great Hill, a debut release on Atlantic Records. She created and starred in critically acclaimed musical adaptations of Shakespeare's Twelfth Night and As You Like It. At Free Shakespeare in the Park, as part of their community-based program, Public Works. These adaptations have now received hundreds of productions worldwide. She also is a member of the Resistance Revival Chorus, the Working Family Party's Artist Council, and co-chairs the NYCLU's Artist Ambassadors. Let's give her a warm welcome to the stage, Shaina Taub!
Wow, this is not intimidating at all. Hi everyone, hey Bryant Park! Under the green wood tree, under the green wood tree.
worst and all the best. Still I will love, still I will love. When we lose all our hair and our teeth and our minds, still I will love, still I will love. Never seen or evolved in that mess of my lines. Still I will love, still I will love.
Beautiful. This is so beautiful. I love outdoor stuff in New York on a beautiful summer night. It's my favorite thing. When they asked me to do this, I was so, so excited. Those last two songs are from As You Like It. I think we've got, yeah, some public works people in the house that we got to do last summer in the Delacorte Theater, another beautiful outdoor New York space for free arts. And I've gotten to see a lot of high school students do these shows, which is so moving to me because I did. My high school show was like my whole life. Like nothing was more high stakes than the high school play, right? But what really strikes me watching students perform my stuff is they're just so fearless and they just do it with such abandon. And I'm like, I used to feel that way. And so I've been trying to kind of get back to that high school play feeling. So this song is sort of a note to self about that. Tell me who you're trying so hard to impress. Tell me who you're so scared to let down. Tell me why you care so much what they think of you now. What happened to the kid in the school play? Told to blend in but singing out loud anyway. You never used to be afraid of what they say. What changed? What changed? Tell me when did you stop trusting yourself? When did you start to doubt your worth? Remember how good it feels to believe in your magic, your magic. Oh,
stop trusting yourself? What if you always know your worth? Remember how good it feels to believe in your magic, your magic. What if you could accept yourself again? What if you hold your
like a group of teens juggling back there, and it's very, I know, I just put them on the spot. Wow, the power I feel. But they're very, it's very calming, so please keep juggling. It's really nice. When I'm feeling nervous, I look at you and I see the juggling, and it's like, I don't know, it's centering, it's a meditation. So yeah, nice job. Okay, so this next song is off my album from last year. It's called Tikkun Olam. Any Jews in the house? Yeah! People always ask me what my genre is, and I never know what to say, and I've started to say that my genre is heavy shtetl. So tikkun olam is a phrase that means to fix the broken world, to leave the world better than you found it. Great concept, right? It just has, it applies to social justice and trying to, you know, improve your community and use the tools that you have to make the world a better place. And I was like, what a great concept, and tikkun olam, what a, like, awesome percussive phrase. We need a song. We need like a song for, we need like a Hakuna Matata for tikkun olam. And so I tried to write one, and this is that, and it's meant to be done outside. You know, it's like about, you know, the tradition of music in the streets for a cause. It's called tikkun olam. And so think about what tikkun olam is for you. Your tikkun olam might be registering people in your community to vote. It might be, you know, calling your elected officials and trying to fight for everyone in your community to have good housing and education, healthcare, you know, like whatever tikkun olam is for you, go for it. Tikkun olam, tikkun olam, tikkun olam. you want to hear a brand new song?
Yes!
I love asking that at shows because you have no choice but to say yes. Like, what are you going to be like? Nah. Like, anyway, but it's exciting. It's a new song. Yes! Okay, this song, this is just kind of how I've been feeling lately. I'm sorry, but no, your email did not find me well. It found me feeling like some sort of washed up in a hollowed out shell. 'Cause I've spent the first third of my life frantically climbing this ladder. But it gives me great pleasure to share. I've discovered this shit doesn't matter. So, death to ambition! That's the last F-bomb I'll drop, I promise. This is a family show. We've reached a very exciting moment in the set because I have a friend here, and she is one of the greatest performers in this world. You might think hyperbole, but no, it's not. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, my friend, my dear muse, star of Suffs, Tony nominee, Jenn, Colella!
But I am saved. I've never read a holy book, but I am saved. 'Cause I know that to sing is to pray. I may never know religion, but I have faith. I never learned communion, but I am saved. Had me no bat mitzvah, but I am saved. 'Cause I know that to sing is to pray. I may never know the gospel, but I have faith. I celebrate holidays secularly. I believe we evolved molecularly. Don't know who to thank for making girls and boys, but I will make a joyful
transition. All right. So, you know, not to bring down the park, but I'm worried about the planet. And, you know, it's just a scary time to be human on this earth that we're trying to take care of. And it just got me thinking about, like, what is the role of the musician in the apocalypse? And so in this TED Talk, I'm just kidding. But I wrote this song just thinking about what would we play, you know, at the end of times, what song would we play? And in playing this Imagine song, how can we do everything in our power to avoid that future? ¶¶ Can you hear my accordion? Okay. This is the last song on earth. There's only time for one before we're burned up by the sun. The soil is toxic and the water's gone. No more hills left to die on. The smoke's getting bad. Why bother to rehearse? We could be goners by the second verse. The fire's coming and the flood is near. Pick your poison, the end is here. This is the last song on earth. Hope you got your money's worth. Let's surrender and sing along, 'cause this is the last song. God bless the jugglers. These are some more new songs. We're trying them out. We're trying them out in this very casual gig. And these songs are about just trying to go easier on yourself. All right, give yourself a break. If you're a perfectionist, if you're really hard on yourself, I really know what that's like. And let's try and be better to ourselves, okay? That's what the songs are about.
The world ain't always gonna take time for you, so whatever.
self. You'll never be this mean to your friends. So why don't you sit yourself down and make amends? Please, 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 be careful with yourself.
This is Monica Tulia Ramirez. This is Princess Victome. This is Debbie Jung. I mean, have you ever seen three more badass women in music? They blow me away. And that's Hiroyuki Matsuura on the drums. Matsu was on my first gig with me in 2009 at Bowery Poetry Club. and he remains the hardest working, greatest drummer and man ever. He's the best. Give it up for Matsu!
Matsu!
And that's David Farrell Melton, who you've already met.
Woo-hoo!
He's just learning how to play piano, so just like go easy.
Be nice.
So I think why I sort of feel the sense of peace playing for you all against all the anxiety I'm also feeling, and besides the jugglers, is like, remember when we couldn't do this? Like, this was taken from us, the ability to gather and be together and hear music and in this city, and I'm just so grateful that we can do it again, that we can come together in these beautiful spaces for free live music in the summertime. And, you know, back a couple years ago, when sort of, you know, I often do free Shakespeare at the Park at the Delacorte, and when we found out that that wouldn't be happening, I would kind of go, like, hang out around the Delacorte like a weirdo. I would just, like, pace around the empty Delacorte in that summer. And it's right by Turtle Pond behind Belvedere Castle. And so I just wrote this song as sort of an ode for Turtle Pond in the time when we could not be making music there. And it's just so beautiful to get to play it on a night where we finally can.
One summer I went walking up the great hill in the park. The city seemed to sigh in sweet relief. The meadows filled with families, the dogwoods were in bloom. The newborn night was smiling like a thief. I heard odes upon the hawthorns as I took the bridal path toward the people in the line to see the play. As the balladeer warmed up, I tossed a dollar in a cup, praying, please, let it always be this way. We sang beneath the stars as the fireflies filled the lawn. We danced despite the rain as the food of love played on. Every heavy heart that flied her past the castle and beyond on Turtle Pond. On Turtle Pond, ooh, Turtle Pond, ooh. Last summer I went walking down the hill I know so well. The city seemed to sink in tired grief. The benches all were barren, the buskers never showed. I crossed the Gothic bridge in disbelief. I heard elegies on brambles for the loved ones we have lost, and echoes of the laughter we once knew. Outside the Delacorte, a fellow sort of shook his head and said, oh God, what are we gonna do? If only we could sing beneath the stars as the fireflies light the lawn, and dance despite the rain as the food of love plays on. Every heavy heart is wishing we could wave a magic wand on Turtle Pond, on Turtle Pond. Sitting empty, stages laid bare. But someday, some summer, I will meet you there. And we will sing beneath the stars as the fireflies light the lawn. We'll dance despite the rain as the food of love plays on. Every heavy heart will beckon, and together we'll respond on Turtle Pond. You're never on time. the sound of your snoring could be considered a crime. But out of everyone I've ever met, honey, I hate you the least. Honey, I hate you the least. The people I come across rub me the wrong way. They've either got much too much or much too little to say. Still out of everyone I've ever met, honey, I hate you the least. Honey, I hate you the least. And I know I can be a pain in the ass. I leave my dirty laundry all over the floor. I'm impatient and stubborn as anything. And still I hope you hate everybody else a little more. 'Cause honey, without you I would be toast. You're last on my shit list. That's why I love you the most. So out of everyone I've ever met, honey, I hate you the least. Honey, I hate you the least. Honey, I hate you. Honey, I hate you. Honey, I hate you the least.
Thank you. So this next song, my good friend Nikki M. James was supposed to come, and she has a beautiful young daughter, Isla, and she's with her tonight. So I am standing in. I'm going to sing this song. This is from my musical adaptation of Twelfth Night that Nikki starred in. And yeah, I'm not going to give a disclaimer about how I haven't rehearsed this because we own what we do. This is the self-talk. I'm improving it. How am I doing? Okay, ready?
You're a full-grown woman.
I can tell you anything, my friend, except how I feel about you, 'cause I know you don't return it. My friend, I'm not myself around you, but I like who I am turning into, 'cause I've missing parts of me, but when I'm with you, I feel put back together, and I know I shouldn't say it. Baby, why don't you say it? Is this not love? Is this not love that I feel for you? Do you feel it too? Despondent, stressed like confidence, a lamb in lion's clothes. I wanna hold you so bad, and I'm not the one you chose. Sometimes your eyes catch mine, and I did think it. Oh, I think you know it. Is this not love? Is this not love? Two is
Okay, we reached another very exciting moment in the show. I'm bringing another incredible friend to the stage. She's an amazing artist, rapper, spoken word, writer. She goes by many names. One of them is Skirt Vonnegut, I just learned, which I love. Sheree J. Davis. Okay, so this is a song. Hey. This is a song that I wrote with my best friend, Kate Ferber. And we wrote it in 2017. You remember 2017? I was going to say a simpler time, but very much not a simpler time. But, yeah, do you remember when he who must not be named Turtle Man, his name rhymes with Shmish Mishmonel, and he said, he was talking about how Elizabeth Warren spoke out of turn, and he said, she was wrong, she was given an explanation, nevertheless, she persisted. You know, and like feminism was like, that's ours, we're taking it back. And it was like, nevertheless, she persisted, shirts, totes, mugs, bags, yes, all this great stuff. And me and Kate were on the subway platform one night, and we're like, let's make a song, come on, let's make a hook. And so we wrote this song. And then we brought in the amazing Sheree to do the rap on the record. And yes, oh, here for a treat. And you know, it's 2023 now, and I know that it's a hard time for women. We have faced so many rollbacks of our rights in this country. But I feel the sense of hope going into our election next summer, next fall. You know, Ohio just took a great stand for reproductive freedom. You know, I believe in our ability to organize and to stand up for our rights and do that together. So tonight, just like, I know we're all exhausted from all of the rough news that you read, but like, let's use this as an opportunity to get fired up together for the fights ahead and to stick it to Shmish McConnell.
She was warned. She was given an explanation. Nevertheless, she persisted.
Nevertheless, Elizabeth, she took the floor, then she took a breath and read without qualms a letter Coretta Scott King wrote strong. They censored her, the congressman said, the senator will take her seat, and all through the chamber caused a stir. They got on the bus to send her. The gunman said, who is Malala? She was more, she was given an explanation. Nevertheless, she persisted. Nevertheless, she persisted. Nevertheless, she persisted. Nevertheless, she persisted. Before. Yes, you've seen this in hashtag form. You heard it first on the Senate floor. He thought he was silencing, but instead he penned the hook. We could be licensing. My volume was heightening. You could try to turn this track down or off, belittle or scorn, but our transmittal is cyclical, generational waves are being hushed. But a crash of sound, the tide of justice comes down. It's gravitational. We could spend all these bars on Joan of Arc, Harriet Tubman, Alice Bonham, Rosa Parks, Sonia Sotomayor. I need a hill. Hermione and Leia, Bessie and Nina, your mama, as well as mama. The first female president is alive at this moment, in a classroom raising her fist, standing on the shoulders of a miss on this list, and nevertheless, she gonna persist. Nevertheless, she persisted. Nevertheless, she persisted. Huh. Nevertheless, she persisted. Nevertheless,
nevertheless,
she persisted.
Huh.
Nevertheless,
see, now they gonna try to kill the sound.
us down. And they gon' run till the sound. But nevertheless, they won't ever keep us down. She persisted, nevertheless.
Sheree J. Davis. Oh, my goodness. All right, this is a song. You know, there's a great canon of songs about the city that we all love so much, and this is my humble contribution. This is called Oh Luck Outrageous. There's an old cathedral on Second Avenue, tightly pressed between two buildings. The stained glass peeking past bodegas. It is ours, you are to me. A thing of ancient beauty glowing among the pallor. I walk by it and feel a heavy lightness rising in my shoes. And every stranger is an angel for a second time. There's an old piano in Washington Square, a baby grand upon the concrete, concertos for the birds and tourists. It is as you are me, a thing of ancient beauty. This has been so beautiful. I've always dreamed of getting to play one of these free New York summer stages. I'm so grateful to everyone at Bryant Park. Give it up for our Parks and Rec department here in New York City. I'm so honored to be representing Joe's Pub tonight. A lot of you, I'm sure I see you downtown. I play there once a month, and it is just the heartbeat, I feel like, of music in the city, that place. And I'm just so grateful to have found a home there and to get to bring it uptown here, midtown, where are we? And I wanna just take another second before we end the show to thank this incredible band, David Farrell Melton, Hiroyuki Matsuura, Debbie Tjong, Princess Victome, Monica Tulia Ramirez. This is rare, this kind of talent and genius is rare and special, and it's even more rare and special when they're compassionate, loving, caring human beings. And I just feel really lucky to get to play with all of you. And this is our first time playing in this ensemble, and it's just been such a beautiful, beautiful process, and I'm grateful to you. Okay, as the sun sets and it gets a little darker, let's just try and, like, I just would love for everyone to get to leave the park tonight with some sense of hope. So this is just my offering to you.
Can you feel the possibility?